So hi, we're here in Richmond, and I want to introduce you to James Jackson, a member of my team for the upcoming local government elections. James, it's a pleasure to have you with us. Tell me about your connection to the Hawkesbury.
Well, I met my partner at the Macquarie Arms Hotel back in 2016.
Nothing more Australian.
Prior to that, I was living overseas in Singapore. Mm-hmm. I also spent a decade in Melbourne, but originally from the hills. Mm-hmm. So right next door. And we'd come up here to do my water skiing. Mm-hmm. Don't hold that against me. But would love nothing more than having a beer out at the Bird in Hand down at Pittstown.
Indeed. Or the Settlers Arms out at St Albans or any of our other historic pubs. And you're living out at Tennyson now.
Absolutely. It's God's country. Yeah. I love it.
So tell me, what's your life or professional experience?
For my sins, I was in banking for 25 plus years, and that's what took me to Singapore, where I ran a team.
Mm. And tell me, lastly, what's important to you in terms of the coming council elections and what Hawkesbury Council could or should be doing?
Oh, look, I think for any council, very important role, the fundamentals, which would be the three R's. You've got to get your rubbish and your roads and your rates right.
Mm-hmm.
So beyond those three R's, those fundamental things of council, we've got a very unique and special place here in the Hawkesbury. Mm-hmm. With the four Macquarie towns, and as you look around here, the fantastic traditions and architecture that make this place quite unique.
And no, it's that very, very unique important. And very special. And you know, we can do better than what we see elsewhere, in the sense that, you know, even if you're in favour of development, certainly we would agree that there are kinds of development that we couldn't countenance that are not consonant with what the Hawkesbury is about. And in the same way, those particular jewels that we have in terms of our historic buildings and our tourist destinations, the roads and paths and bush locations and the ecotourism, I see council not really picking up the ball and giving those the support that they deserve.
I would love to see our small businesses in the Hawkesbury really cash in on what we have here, this unique and beautiful part of the world where people from all around Sydney are naturally drawn, especially those that are drawn to the water, those on two wheels who just like to be outside. And of course, just up the Putty Road, you get to the beautiful Blue Mountains. Mm-hmm. All of these things really pull in tourists, local tourists from all around Sydney. Mm-hmm. I'd really love to maximise that as much as possible.
Well,
it is quite unique.
Well, James, I'm particularly grateful to have you on the team and to endorse the candidacy of I and my teammates as part of the team. You bring an enormous amount of business acumen and also life experience, having lived and worked overseas and then anchoring yourself here in the Hawkesbury now. So James is a part of my team, and we hope that this helps you come to a more considered vote about the upcoming council elections, which are due on the 4th of December, and pre-poll and postal votes will open far sooner. And without the ability to hand out any material at polling places, we're reliant on you sharing material like this to your friends and neighbours so that you understand that there are people that are going to work hard for you in the coming term of Hawkesbury Council. Thanks for watching.